Sarawak Chief Minister Datuk Patinggi Abang Johari Tun Abang Openg sat down with the Star for an interview at his house recently. He spoke about his administration's fight to address the erosion of power in the largest state of Malaysia.
Under the Malaysian Agreement, there was supposed to be a panel to review the implementation of policies agreed under the Malaysian Agreement. 10 years after the formation of Malaysia, headed by the late Tun Dr. Ismail. As you know, Tun Ismail died between 1974-75. After that, the Prime Minister also died. Tun Hussein all became Prime Minister after Tun Hatta. And everybody seemed to, you know, to forget about that panel. I passed it through the council degree. And we have appointed our 3 DCM to lead the panel from Sarawak. And I'm waiting for the federal side, for instance, in oil and gas. We can work together. But to call the shot, it must be Sarawak. Assuming I got a reserve of oil and gas on land, and we are not a member of National Land Council. We are just observer. So meaning that is exclusive right of Sarawak. Because if you are happy, Malaysia is happy. But if you have a member of your family not happy, the family will be fragmented.
He also said Pakatan Harapan Chairman Tun Dr. Mahathir Mohamad should make way for young leaders in the coming general election. He predicted that Barisan Nasional will do well by winning at least 25 out of 31 parliamentary seats in Sarawak.
If I base on the last performance of state election, and if you know the ingredients including MA63 in there, I believe that we can maintain that 25. If not, we may gain 1 or 2 seats more. The Chinese one, whether the economy is going right or not. Because it affects the business. If Datuk Najib has a policy that is conducive to investment, then the business going quite well. Why not? We don't care about 1 MDB. Because 1 MDB, I mean, we got the loss there. Let the law take its course.
Sarawak has become a beacon of moderation for many people, and the Chief Minister wants to keep it that way.
In the Malanau community, within one village, you get Christian and Muslim. Within the family, living together. That's the reason why we ban personalities to come to Sarawak.
How many people have you banned?
Yeah, of course lah, including your Jamal lah. Because the question is not that we do not want.
Yes.
We know that they have extreme views. So yeah. We say, okay, don't come over the side.
Since taking office in January 2017, the 67-year-old Chief Minister has proposed a light rail transit system in Kuching and buses that run on hydrogen. He has also allocated 1 billion ringgit to build internet infrastructure for digital economy in Sarawak.